Hi, I'm Lindsay Rebhan from Ecological Design.
And I'm Eric Berg with Berg Brothers.
We're here at the Main Street Project Farm. It's a research demonstration farm in Northfield, Minnesota. And we've worked together for a long time on many projects, and we're really excited about this one. Water is super important, water and soil building, to jumpstart the land. We're transitioning from a very old system of many years of corn on corn and conventional agriculture, transitioning over to more perennialized lands with livestock. So we're starting with the water, and we have a lot of wetlands and a lot of water surrounding this entire property. And when we first got here, we saw a lot of tire tracks, a lot of machinery stuck, a lot of areas that shouldn't have been farmed were being continuously plowed. And so we have a massive amount of erosion on this hill behind us, and all of the good black topsoil eroded down to the bottom land. So Eric has been working on creating swales, waterways, grass waterways, and some ponds to harvest that water, and then taking the productive soil and making it into more production area.
We're looking at what are the factors, what do the designers want from us, and what do the clients want. And then we have to see what we actually have when we get on the ground. So we knew there was a road going about here. We knew we were going to put a pond and some swales in certain locations. What we were hoping to do was dig the first pond and find subsoil or inorganic soil that would build a road. We didn't find the material we were looking for, so that changed things up a bit. And then we went back to scraping the black back from where the road was going and mining the subsoil or the inorganic soil as close to the road as we could. We're lifting up these areas where we had sort of a pond there already. It was a depression that stayed wet all the time, and you weren't gonna plant trees or vegetables in it. We created an area to hold water, but then we also use that material to build up the soil directly around it to change it from marginal land that's sometimes wet to a more useful, more often piece of property.
This is a larger scale example of what we can do, but we can do this on all size properties. So Eric, if someone's wanting to do this, if a farmer's wanting to do this on their land, what kind of, you know, we're standing in front of a D6 dozer, but how can farmers do this on their own land?
You know, I guess you'd have an idea of how you wanted to start, but you could do it, you could do it as by hand, you could do it with a tractor and a plow, you could bobcat or, just about anything. You could change the way the water flows on your property. You don't have to have this, it's one way to do it and get a lot done in a hurry, but there's lots of ways to do it. There's lots of small scale stuff you can do that could make big changes, or at least convince you that you'd want to do more.
Mm-hmm. And so we're always moving towards a perennialized system, but we will till the soil to start a project or flip the soil if we need to. So as we're building this up, we're prioritizing water on this land because it's such a design driver, it's surrounding here. Once we know that, we know the biological system of the farm is going to be able to be kickstarted much faster. And so we'll finish this project up in the spring of the earthworks, and then the crops and the ground covers and the livestock will arrive next year in 2018. Now it's summertime, nice and warm, and we're feeling really good where the farm is at. Everything has greened up, and we have our ground covers in. We're on our second rotation of cover crops, about to enter into our final perennial rotation. We got our woody agroforestry cups in. Our hybrid hazelnuts have all been planted, 12,500. We got our asparagus crop in. And we're really excited about how the pond has filled up. And we continue to observe and interact with a lot of the complexities of this property around the drain tiles, potential contamination from outside sources. We have the overflow bioswale that seeded in native grasses into our wetland areas. We're noticing the drain tile, the old drain tile, still filling up some of our wetland areas, and so we're going to work with that process and see what we need to do in order to minimize disturbance from those broken drain tiles. We have a large amount of wildlife that's starting to show up on the farm fields, which is a good feedback sign for us. We're still looking forward to getting the coops built for our chickens, the first of the coops by the end of this year, and getting our animals integrated into the farm. And we are very excited to be stabilizing the site to allow our water to spread and sink into the ground here.